I am Dr. Mithilesh Nayan Bhatt, Assistant Professor of Law at Sardar Patel University of Police Security and Criminal Justice, Jodhpur, Rajasthan. Under the subject of Police Science and Law, today's module name is Citizen Rights During Investigation. Now, what are the learning outcome of this module? This is to make the learners understand the rights of a citizen during investigation. Then, to make the learners understand the rights of victim, accused, complainant, and others. Then, to make the learners understand the rights of women and child during investigations. Now, just to start introduction, we have the human beings are born free and equal in dignity and rights. This principle of Universal Declaration of Human Rights, 1948, is applicable to all walks of life. On same note, we as a human being may encounter with criminal justice system, sometimes as accused or witnesses or victim or as a normal citizen. Every police officer must be aware of the legal rights of various individuals to enable him to respect such rights, not only statutory, but also to earn the goodwill of the public. Citizens interact with criminal justice system in many roles, like as complainant, as victim, as accused, and as witnesses. Similarly, these same play a greater role during investigation also. Now, human rights of different section of public. Now, human rights of victim. In 1985, the UN Declaration recognizes four basic rights of victim in UN General Assembly in document Basic Principle of Justice for Victims of a Crime and Abuse of Power, which are access to free and fair treatment, where judicial and administrative mechanisms that are responsible to the victims. Victims be treated with respect and compassion and are given their right to redressal. Restitution is important part in this. The victim and their families must be entitled to fair restitution for expenses incurred because of victimization. Return of property harmed made. Then compensation. The state must pay fair compensation to the victims and their families if such compensation is not fully available from the offender for significant bodily injury or mental agony. And then assistance required. The victim must be informed of the assistance mechanism in place, and the police, health, and other officials must be sensitized to the needs and problems of the victims. And assistance programs through governmental or voluntarily means be provided to the victims. Then next is, what is the Indian legal position on victim? Victim can engage advocate to support and help the prosecution under Section 24 of the CRPC. And its proviso says that the court may permit the victim to engage an advocate of his choice to assist the prosecution. Statement of the victim to be done in a safe place or a place of her choice and by a woman police officer for women under Section 157 of the CRPC. In subsection 1, after the provision that in relation to an offences of a rape, the recording of a statement of the victim shall be conducted at the residence of the victim or in the place of her choice and as far as practicable by a woman police officer in the presence of her parents or guardian or near relatives or social worker of the locality. In section 161 of CRPC, statements may also be recorded by audiovisual electronic means. Under section 164 of the CRPC provisions that any confession or statement made under this subsection may also be recorded by audio video electronic means in the presence of the advocate of the person accused of an offense, under further that no confession shall be recorded by a police officer on whom any power of magistrate has been conferred under any law for the time being in force. Witness can be done by using electronic means, that is under section 275 of CRPC, and the following proviso shall be inserted in which state that provided evidence of a witness under this subsection may also be recorded by audio-video electronic means in the presence of the advocate of the person accused of the offence. In Section 173 of CRPC, investigation of a child sex abuse to be done in time-bound manner. In Section 275 CRPC, witness can be done by using electronic means. Now, there is a victim compensation scheme under Section 357A of CRPC. A scheme for compensation says, every state government in coordination with the central government shall prepare a scheme for providing funds for the purpose of compensation to the victim or his dependents who have suffered loss or injury as a result of the crime and who require rehabilitation. Power to decide quantum of compensation depend upon the recommendation is made by the court for compensation, the district or the state legal service authority, as the case may be, shall decide the quantum of compensation on to be awarded under the scheme of aforesaid. Inadequate compensation or compensation in cases of acquittal or discharge, if the trial court at the conclusion of the trial is satisfied that the compensation awarded under Section 357 CRPC is not adequate for such rehabilitation, or where the cases end in acquittal or discharge and the victim has to be rehabilitated, it may make recommendation for compensation. Compensation on when offender is untraceable. Where offender is untraceable or unidentified, but the victim is identified, and where no trial take place, the victim or his dependent may make an application to the state or district legal service authority for award of compensation, on which shall be decided after due inquiry, awarded adequate compensation by completing the inquiry within 2 months. Then collateral relief to victim also available. The state or the district legal service authority, as the case may be, to lessen the suffering of the victim, may order for immediate first aid facility or medical benefits to be made available free of cost on the certificate of the police officer. Supreme Court in 2011 in the case of Ankur Shivaji Gaikwad versus State of Maharashtra has observed that a long line of judicial pronouncement of a Supreme Court of India recognized a paradigm shift in the approach of victim of crime who are held entitled to reparation, restitution, compensation for loss or injury suffered by them. Then the core rights for victim of crime included the right to attend criminal justice proceedings, then the right to apply for compensation, the right to be heard and participate in criminal justice proceedings, then the right to be informed of proceedings and events in the criminal justice process, of legal rights and remedies, and of available services, the right to protection from intimidation and harassments, then the right to restitution from the offenders, then next right to prompt return of personal property seized as evidence, then the right a speedy trial and the right to enforcement of these rights. Then human rights of witnesses also available. Witnesses of any crimes are having some specific rights against police action, like examine witnesses at their place and do not call them to police station unless it is necessary. Examine women and children at their place of residence, and witnesses are there to help investigation. Therefore, deal with them courteously. Child witnesses should be handled with special care. Then further, human rights to suspects and accused also available during investigation, where accused have some specific rights against police action, like right to know the grounds of arrest under Section 50 CRPC and Article 22 of Indian Constitution. It provisions that every police officer or other person arresting any person without warrant shall communicate to him full particulars of the offence for which he is arrested or other grounds for such arrest. Next right is to inform of the provision for bail, which is under Section 50, Subclause 2 and Article 22 of Indian Constitution, where a police officer arrests any person other than a person accused of a non-bailable offence without warrant, he shall inform the person arrested that he is entitled to be released on bail and that he may arrange for sureties on his behalf. Then right to free legal aid also available under Article 21 of Indian Constitution and Section 304 of CRPC to defended by their legal practitioner appropriately available for them for fairness of the trial. Then right to be taken to magistrate without delay under Section 57 CRPC and Article 22 of Indian Constitution, where person who is arrested and detained in custody shall be produced before the nearest magistrate within a period of 24 hours of such arrest, excluding the time necessary for the journey. Then, under Section 76, which contains a similar provision for a person arrested under a warrant. Now, under Article 22 of Indian Constitution, the arrested person is entitled to consult any one of his choice, and it shall not be denied as per Section 303 of CRPC. The accused charged of any offence has a right to be defended by an advocate of his choice. The next right is to be informed about the right to arrest his relatives or friend. In order to ensure a fair trial and to improve people-police relationship, the Supreme Court in Joginder Kumar v. State of UP in 1994 formulated the rules that make it mandatory on the police officer to inform one friend or relative or any other person of the accused persons of his own choice about his arrest. These rules were later incorporated in CRPC under Section 50 in 2005. Section 50A provides that the police officer must inform the arrested person of this right. Further, as per Section 50A, he must note down the name and address of the person who was informed about the arrest. While surveillance prescribed in the police regulations authorized by law and approved by the Supreme Court in 1975 made permissible unnecessary intrusion into the privacy of person is forbidden. Avoid any unnecessary interference with the right to privacy. Interrogation must be within the legal framework. Prolonged detention in the name of interrogation may amount to harassment and ultimately turn out as wrongful confinement. Searches of places and more so dwelling houses have to be made strictly in accordance with the law and procedure laid down under Section 100 of CRPC. Police officer entering dwelling houses for searches should observe decency and decorum, respecting the sentiments of women while discharging their duty. The assistance of women constable or women witnesses must be taken while searching the person of a woman. Then, any unlawful search not only violates or vitiates the purpose but gives opportunity to the accused to use the right of private defense. Then attempts to torture, accuse or suspect to obtain confession are not only an offense under Section 330 or 331 of IPC, but it is useless as such evidence is not admissible under law. Under Article 20, Clause 3 of the Indian Constitution says that no accused should be forced physically or psychologically to say anything which is likely to be self-incriminatory. Then there should be no arbitrary arrest. All arrest must strictly conform to the requirement of law and procedure. Arrest need not to be made just because a police officer has a power to arrest. The necessity to confine is the principle behind the law. The arrested person shall not be subjected to more restraint than is necessary to prevent his escape, that is under Section 49 of CRPC. Handcuffs should not be used without the order of the court. an accused person arrested shall have the right to be examined by medical practitioners, that is under section 54 of CRPC. In case of Sheela Barse versus State of Maharashtra in 1983, Supreme Court held that the arrested accused person must be informed by magistrate about his right to be medically examined in terms of section 54 CRPC during custody. The arrested person is entitled for fair treatment and no custodial torture or ill treatment is permissible. Then most of the custodial deaths take place during illegal detention. Produce the accused within 24 hours of the arrested and obtain police custody from the court for interrogation if necessary. This will increase the responsibility of police and minimize irresponsible custodial tortures. Then, what is the human rights of complainant, where any citizen who has knowledge of preparation or commission of any crime or who has any complainant to make with reference to the duties of the police as enumerated above can approach the police station and give such information available with him or her. If any such information furnished to the police at the police station discloses the commission of a cognizable offence, a first information report, which is FIR, shall be reduced to writing by the officer in charge of the police station, and a copy of the FIR shall be given forthwith to the complainant who gave the information leading to the registration of FIR free of cost, which is under section 154 of the CRPC. Then, if the complainant or information is given orally, it is the duty of the station house officer of the police station approached to reduce the said complaint into writing, read it over to the complainant, and on his or her acceptance about the correctness of the recorded statement, obtain his or her signature and issue the FIR. If any station house officer refuses to take cognizance of the complaint which discloses a cognizable offence, the concerned citizen can send the substance of such information in writing by post or hand it over in person to the superintendent of police of the district having jurisdiction over that police station. Then next is the concerned superintendent of police, if satisfied that information disclosed the commission of a cognizable offence, then he shall either investigate the case himself or herself or direct an investigation to the made by police officer subordinate to him under section 154 of CRPC. In case the complaint made to the police officer by the citizen does not disclose the commission of any cognizable offence, the concerned police officer in charge of the police station can refuse to investigate into the complaint. He shall enter or cause to be entered the substance of the information disclosing a non-cognizable offence in station diary. Refer the informant to the magistrate under section 155 subclause 1 of CRPC. If the complainant is not satisfied by the refusal of the police to register a case on his or her complaint, he or she can approach the court and, if directed by the court in writing, the concerned police officer shall register the case and investigate as per order of the court. Now, if such complaint is made in writing, the station house officer of the police station must issue an acknowledgement for having received the complaint. In case the place of occurrence of the offence does not fall in the jurisdiction of the police station at which the complaint has been made or the FIR has been registered, the station house officer, after registering the FIR, should transfer the case to the police station having jurisdiction over the place of occurrence and inform the complainant regarding this transfer. This fact has to mention in the FIR itself. On the ground of jurisdiction alone, issue of FIR should not be refused or delayed. Under Section 173, subclause 2 of CRPC, after completion of investigation, the investigating officer should send written information under acknowledgement to the complainant informing him of the exact nature of the final report of the investigation in the case. Then, human rights of women in investigation process. Women as accused, witness or victim of any crime are having some specific rights against police action, and same are recommended by an expert committee on custodial justice to women, Government of India in 1983, where they says women shall be shown special treatment wherever they interfere with the system, whether as complainant or victim or accused or witnesses or inmates of institution, giving respect for gender dignity of women. Separate prisons and police lockups, correctional centers and separate counters shall be set up exclusively to deal with the women. Recognizing the children of custodialized women as innocent, the state shall conscientiously respect the rights and privileges of the children accompanying the women in custody. The police, prison and correctional or judicial personnel dealing with the women shall be specially trained, and women shall be arrested only in case of absolute necessity and only between the sunrise and sunset, except in exceptional cases. Arrest and search of the women, including interrogation, shall be conducted according to strict standard of decency. Women police officers shall search women and escort women prisoners. Basic amenities and privacy shall be provided to women prisoners. No woman or male person under age of 15 years shall be required to attend at any place other than the place in which such male persons or women resides, which is under Section 160 of CRPC. In camera trials and identification protection, under Section 327 of the CRPC, provided that in camera trials shall be conducted as far as practicable by a woman judge or magistrate. Further, in subsection 3 of the Section 327 CRPC, the proviso inserted which says that provided the ban on printing or publication of trial proceeding in relation to an offense of rape may be lifted subject to maintaining confidentiality of name and address of the parties. Now, what are the human rights of juveniles or children? Juvenile Justice Care and Protection of Children Act 2015, as we know, is a human right legislation and is enacted to lay down procedure while dealing with the neglected and delinquent juveniles. Some of the important points which related to juveniles in investigation process, where when a juvenile delinquent, if arrested for committing any offense, shall not be kept in lockups nor handcuffed. He shall be released on bail whether the offense is bailable or non-bailable, provided an undertaking is given by his parents or guardians to take care of him and for production in court. If anybody does not offer surety, he shall be forwarded to the observation home pending inquiry. Interrogate juveniles delinquent with sympathy, care and caution. Question the juveniles not in isolation and never be authoritative. Be kind but firm with the juveniles. Whenever a statement is to be recorded from a juvenile's witness, keep him at ease and make him to speak the truth away from the influences. Do not launch security proceedings against a juvenile. Investigations of child sex abuse to be done in time-bound manner. Under Section 173 CRPC, which says the investigation in relation to rape of a child may be completed within 3 months from the date of which the information was recorded by the officer in charge of the police station. Now, along with the rights, there are duties and responsibilities of citizens. Every right goes with a corresponding obligations. Every citizen should know his or her jurisdictional police station and its telephone numbers. Then, citizens should also inform the nearest police station or dial 100 to report on the perpetrator of any of the following offences, like falling within the ambit of the Indian Penal Code. Against the state or citizen, such as an act of terrorism, that must be reported. Any suspicion activities in neighborhood which may affect their safety and security must be informed. Offenses against peace and tranquility of the city and offenses against involving corruption, illegal gratification, or offenses against adulteration of food, stuff, and superior drugs and medicines, and offenses against a person involved in murder, grievous injuries, kidnapping, robbery, dacoity, theft, etc. must be reported, and offenses against property such as house trespass, lurking houses trespass, mischief against property, etc. must be reported. Against criminal breach of trust by public servants, it will be the endeavor of the police to ensure the confidentiality of the informer and to afford to them full protection from any adverse sources. Citizen must cooperate in investigation at times of search, seizures, spot visit, and inquest inquiry. Citizens are encouraged to request for verification of antecedents of domestic helps before employing unknown persons. Now, to summarize all this module, the police are the officers of the state who have the task of investigation of crime. In carrying out this work, the police have a great deal of discretion. During investigation, at one side, police has duty to investigate, whereas citizens have some rights. Citizens can enjoy these rights in forms in which they come into contact of police, like as a complainant, as accused, as victim, or as witnesses, and in other roles. The effective enforcement of rights involves positive and negative obligations at four levels. The first one is the obligation to respect, the obligation to protect, the obligation to ensure, and the obligation to promote the right in questions. The right of citizens are protected by many criminal laws and that need to follow in letter and spirit. Thank you.